Welcome to the Trading with a Bot channel. I had published a series of videos about a DCA bot, which I had called the Tiny Doge Bot. You'll find these videos on YouTube, as I am showing now, if you had not seen them before. One of these videos had covered the topic of backtesting. I used the script developed by Max Ruam, and showed how you would go around finding a good performing DCA setting for your 3, DCA. Today, I want to show you another backtester, and this time you will not need to access TradingView. Instead, you will be accessing this backtesting service via a Discord community called Bot Nerds. I am leaving the access link in the description of the video below, and once you click on the invite URL that I provided, you will need to register, if you've never used Discord before. Once you log into Discord, the link I had provided will take you right to the Bot Nerds community. Next, you'll need to click on the robot emoji as a sign that you've read the terms and conditions of the community, and some of these channels that you're seeing on my screen right now will show up for you as well. Now, I am saying that you'll see just some of the channels, because this community offers both free and paid services, and by default you will only see the free services. Here is the NB, backtester section, and its channels that you should be able to see, and if you do not see it, then please go back to the very top welcome channel and tap the robot emoji again. If you want to see their premium services, you'd need to join their bot gang, and you'll find all of this information in the frequently asked channel. Basically, the community owner has a Patreon page, and he is charging a monthly membership fee for the premium services. Since I am one of his customers, I am a part of the bot gang, and I see this additional section on the left. I will show you some of the content of both paid and free sections, and I will explain how to use this backtesting service. In this video we will focus on the commands that you can use to start a backtest, and on how to read and interpret the results of your tests. I need to remind you that this service, and these backtests, are designed specifically for the 3, bot platform. And thus you should be already familiar with the terms, such as base order, and safety order, and their abbreviations, BO, and SO. There are several other key parameters that are used in 3, DCA bots, and they also have their own abbreviations, SOS, OS, MSTC, SS. All of these parameters, and some others, are used in the backtester command line. I will get into it more in a few minutes. Right now, I am showing the Power Commands channel, and the past commands entered by the members to run their own backtest queries. Here, the last command was run by Philippe. It looks like he was running a backtest on Ethereum. As you see, he entered a command starting with exclamation mark, DCA backtest, on a pair ETH, USDT. I'll cover the other parameters shortly, but some of you may already get an idea of how this works. In the end of his command he wrote SD for start date and ED for end date, and these two define the backtesting period. So the commands channel is the area where you provide your inputs, and to see the results of your query, you switch to the results channel. The engine behind the backtesting is not visible to you, and as I mentioned, you do not even need to open TradingView or any other tools. Here is the last result from the last test that was run by Philippe on Ethereum. These results provide a lot of valuable information as well as a visual representation of the bot's performance. Let me do a few tests of my own, and get into the details of both tests and the results. I need to go back to the commands channel, and issue my own backtesting command. There are instructions on how to run these commands, but I'll just copy the last line that Philippe had run. So, as you see, the backtesting command always starts with an exclamation mark, DCA backtest command, and then as a first parameter, you provide a dash pair, and specify the pair you want to backtest. In my case it is Doge slash USDT. The second argument of the command is the TP, which stands for take profit or target profit. I will provide values I use in my tiny Doge bot, and for target profit I use 0.35%. Next, the BO and SO stand for base order, and safety order, and in both cases these values are equal to 10. The MSTC, stands for max safety trade count, and just like in Philippe's bot, I'm only using 6 safeties. Next, I let it the value for SOS, which stands for safety order step. It is the price deviation to open safety orders, percent from initial order, value. In the case of the tiny Doge, this value is 2.7%. Moving on, the argument OS stands for safety order scale or volume scale, which is 1.9, and the argument SS stands for SS safety order step scale, which in my case is 0.7. Here is the latest tiny Doge bot that I have on my account. Here I'd like to take a moment and to apologize to all of you, because I was not able to keep the same bot running since the summer of 2021, due to various experimental settings I've run on my futures account. Nevertheless, this bot that I am showing is still having all of the original settings from the previous videos. And now we can put together the command that I just entered into the bot nerd's backtester, and the actual DCA settings of the tiny Doge bot. Feel free to pause this video for a moment. Let's make our first backtest on the exact same period that I had my actual bot running. This specific bot had run on my Binance futures account for about 10 days before I paused it. So the remaining parameters for the backtesting command are the -sd that stands for starting date, and ed that denotes the end date. I've had my bot running from January 13, 2022 to January 22nd, and so, I will specify these two dates into the command. You may have noticed that there was also a possibility for me to specify the fee percent, so that the backtest takes that into an account, when computing the ROI. I left the fee value at 0.01. Now as I hit enter, my request was sent to the backend for execution, and I will see the result of these settings in the results channel. It may take up to a minute, depending on how busy the server is. However, when the results will be available, the server will tag your Discord name, and you'll see a red notification, just as I am seeing it now. Here are the results, and I will show you how I interpret them. Going from top to bottom, you'll see the heading, showing the pair that you requested to backtest, and the DCA settings, that you have specified. The backtesting period will be described via the line on the bottom. My start date was 2022-01-13, at 00, and my end date was 2022-01-21 at 2359 UTC. So the bot had run close to 10 days, and one of the features of the bot nerd's backtester is that it calculates both, a daily average ROI and the total ROI percent for the specified period. The total return on investment after these 10 days was 3%, and the average daily ROI was 0.4%. So the y-axis of this graph shows the ROI, and the x-axis is the time duration. Do you see these flat lines? The flat lines, where ROI is not increasing over a period of time, are the durations and time when the bot is stuck. Here the backtester is showing us an average duration of a deal, and here under the max deal time we see the longest period where the bot was stuck, the flat lines. The performance was not so bad. The bot was taken on average 57 minutes to exit with a profit, and got stuck a few times, but the longest time it was stuck was for 21 hours. During the backtesting period the bot had closed 226 trades. Let's see how my actual bot had performed. I see a total of 166 trades, which is 60 trades less than what backtester calculated. My actual total profit was $14.34. I think the difference in the number of trades was caused by the fact that backtester made calculations from midnight to midnight, and my actual performance was slightly shorter. Here you can see that the backtester had calculated a total of profit of $16.56, which is indeed very close to my actual performance, as you saw on the previous screen. I want to point out, that this backtesting tool performs calculations on spot. Or in other words, without any leverage. And so another very useful feature of the results is the total funds required field. Here, it is shown that these settings would require a total of $521.62. Side note, on futures I am using only $27, because I am trading with 20x leverage. As discussed in some of my past videos, leverage does not impact your profits. It only reduces your investment requirements. And now I want to point out another important outcome. Here, the results show you the max funds that were actually used by the bot. The DCA settings of the Tiny Doge bot cover only 7.94% of price deviation, and this is caused by the small number of safety orders and the decreasing step scale. My step scale is 0.7, as you may recall, and I have only 6 safety orders. So when the max funds used equal to the max funds required, it indicates that all of my safety orders were used. I used all of my funds to cover the 7.94% price drop, and look here, the actual max deviation was even bigger, it was 8.95%. This information is especially critical if you plan to run such a bot on futures, as I do. Please write to me in the comments section if you do not understand why it is important. In short, the max deviation shows you the additional drop of the price after you reached your last safety order, and on futures, depending on your maintenance budget, this could mean liquidation. In fact, the markets were continuing to drop from January 20th, so let me go back and extend the backtesting period to include the time when my actual bot was paused. I am extending the period to January 29th. New results are now appearing in the results channel. Surprisingly, the bot did well. I see 438 closed deals and double the previous profit. The max drawdown had increased, as you can see. My bot was still able to cover only 7.94%. Because I have not changed my DCA settings, however, I can see that it was not stuck for a long time. The average deal time and the max deal time are still the same as in a previous backtest. I have another idea for a test. Let's see how the bot had handled the May 9th crash. I had commented on the market crash of May 9th, 2021, in my previous videos, where I covered the aspects of budgeting, and a futures anti-liquidation calculator. I had just modified my backtesting command to run the backtest from 1st of May, 2021 to 1st of June, covering the crash period. Now, as the results appear, we can see a flat line on ROI scale, which starts from May 9th. As I explained, the absence in the further growth of ROI means that the bot is stuck. On May 9th, when the price was dropping rapidly, the bot had reached its 6th SO, and had no possibility to exit. Because the price continued to fall. The drawdown value, as you can see here, is 67.58%, and so with the current settings the Tiny Doge would have never recovered from this drop, and would have stayed as a red bag for a long time. But, what if, instead of a decreasing step scale of 0.7, I had a step scale that was increasing with each new SO? I will modify my SS parameter from the previous value of 0.7 to a new value of 1.2. With this real-life example, I am showing you how to use this backtester tool effectively. I saw that my setting was ineffective, causing a bag, and I modified one of the parameters of my DCA bot. Now, look at the new results. The step scale is now increasing, above 1, and I am able to cover a larger price deviation with my DCA bot. I have a good daily ROI, my overall profits look good, and as I can see, the bot was at maximum idle for a bit over 1 day. It had handled the crash just fine. I have shown you just some of the inner workings of the premium service from the Bot Nerds Discord. Let's take a quick look at the free section now. Again, when you just enter their Discord server for the first time, you'll start with the rules channel, press the robot emoji, and scroll down to find the channels under the NB Backtester section. The command line works exactly as I had shown earlier in this video, with the exceptions you have fewer arguments that you can provide. You can still provide inputs for the pair, TP, BONSO, MSTC, SOS, OS and SS arguments, but you cannot provide the date range. Here I am pasting a command line to backtest the original Tiny Doge bot settings. As mentioned, I cannot specify the backtest date range, because it is not offered for free. Once I execute the command, I go to the results section, just as in the premium service, and I will be able to see all of the metrics that I commented on earlier. The fee amount is defaulted to 0.10, as I could not specify it either, and the back test period is always defaulted to the past 30 days. Aside from these limitations, this free version is perfectly fine to give you a good sense on how your DCA settings would perform against the past 30 days. The issue, of course, arises due to the fact that the last 30 days may have been very bearish or very bullish, so you would not know how your settings would behave against different market conditions, and that is why you may consider the paid service, where you can select specific time range for your back tests. Another benefit of a paid service, as I am showing now, are the power commands. For instance, you can backtest multiple pairs with just one command. That means that the backtester will run the same bot settings for each of the pairs you specified, and will produce an individual result for each of them. As you can see, another bot gang member is doing just that. I will now type the exclamation mark, help, DCA backtest, command, to see all of the available command options. As I mentioned, you can put multiple pairs into one command and run a series of tests for the same settings. You can also have multiple settings in one command, for instance put multiple take profit targets, or specify various base order or safety order sizes, and so on. This may save you a bit of time, and would result in somewhat of a brute force type of a back test. You'll see a number of results appearing once you issue such a power command. You can then analyze the results one by one. Or, you can install one of the tools created by a community member, listed here in the tools channel. I will not go into the details of showing you the tool that aggregates the results. I just wanted to point out that such a tool exists. And with this, I would like to conclude the demonstration of the Bot Nerds Backtester, and definitely urge you to try their free version. The link to their community is in the description of the video below, and as usually, I am here to respond to your comments and feedback. Thanks for watching.